Hey laser lovers, welcome back. So last time we finished all the preparations for the camera using, and this time we're gonna actually use the camera to do some laser cutting and engraving. There are several ways to use your camera. You could use the camera to track the shape of an object. For example, a hammer, or sometimes even like an irregularly shaped object. And of course, you could use the camera to track, say, like your sketch or sometimes your paintings, etc. And then use your laser to cut or engrave them out. In this video, we will show you both ways. So let's get into it. Firstly, let's go to Window and click on Camera Control. And then you can put the laser cut test pattern on the honeycomb table. The one we choose here is Black Butterfly. It will be easier for the camera to capture the dark edge.And then we do autofocus. And then we hit update overlay and trace it. We can zoom in to see more details. Here we have this cutoff button and threshold button. These two will help us to track the perfect trace of the pattern. You can just slide them to get a better and smoother border.Now you might see there are also some extra stuff like this, but don't worry, this can be fixed later. For example, we got these extra dots and circles, but we can delete them by clicking on Ungroup and just delete. Alright, now let's go back to last step because I think we can make the border better than this, right? Just update again and trace it.Select the part that we need and do a few adjustments. Good enough. Let's go to next. And here, theoretically, if we're using this location button, say if I click on exactly here, the laser head will move to the exact same position.But it might still be a little bit off. If it's too much, maybe you need to redo the camera calibration and camera alignment. If you don't know how to do it, just watch this video. Okay, now let's do the parameter settings. And we can go frame.And start. By the way, we keep the lid open for shooting, but please remember to close the lid when the machine is working. Once we finish our first test, we get a cutting result, so we can compare the position of cutting result with the original pattern to see whether this capture is precise enough. And ours is quite good. You can use a ruler to measure the deviation.It's about less than 1 millimeter, so ours is quite good. But we can always try to balance the deviation by adjusting these two, the X and Y shift. You can use them to move them to the better position. We can have a look, like this. So the composition parameters can help us to correct some small deviations.Okay, now let's talk about the usage for the camera. Mainly, there are two of them. Number one, say you had a sketch, and you can use the camera to capture this image, and use the positioning function of the camera to place the sketch on wherever you want it to be engraved on this notebook, like here or here. Or, you really like the shape of some solid object.Still, we can do capture and then have it laser cut out on certain material that you like. But there is one thing that I do need to remind you. As for some solid objects, the reflection and shadow of this object will affect the final result of our capture and trace, because we all know camera can be very sensitive to light, so be aware of that. Okay, let's get down to business.Update overlay and trace it. Select the part that we need. which is this cute puppy Alex. Adjust these parameters for better result. And we go next. Now we have this cute puppy Alex. Of course, you can change the size of it and the position. And now we need to do autofocus for the notebook. The surface is really soft, so I'm really looking forward to see how it looks on my notebook. Let's update again. And I want puppy Alex to be smaller and to be engraved on exactly here. And we can go frame and start. All right, now let's take a look at the result. Well, the edges are pretty clear. Look how cute this is. Good job, and imagine what you can do. Now let's move on to next project. Okay, then again, we hit update overlay and trace it. Zoom in, and we select these two leaves that we need. And we go next. Here, we can use the ungroup thing again so that we get to make individual adjustments for each item. Like I want this one to be smaller and I want this one to stay the same. And of course, this one is for cutting, so we choose different setting parameters. Okay, now let's do autofocus again. And we need to close the buttons for the blue ones. And let's do frame. And we can start. All right, let's see how it looks this time. Well, we might should try to lower the power because the edges are a bit dark. But I think the shape of this and the cutting is pretty good, right? Okay, the job is done. Looking good.
So that's how you use your camera on your laser machine. I'm very looking forward to see your works with the camera. If you find this video helpful, I don't need to tell you what to do, right?